using concept maps whenever I am trying to get my students to understand relationships between data. So whenever I'm setting up a concept map, first thing I have to do is figure out what kind of information I want my kids to know. You find the right map to fit the data that you're looking for, and then it's passing it on to your kids. I chose this specific concept map for my fission and fusion because I looked at my TEEK. My TEEK said compare and contrast fission and fusion. So I knew I needed some kind of graphic organizer that was going to do that. So I picked a bubble chart that had the certain amount of differences and then the certain amount of similarities, and it's very visual for the kids. I chose to use cards to help build this concept map because I was using this as a note-taking device. Now, if I'm using it as a formative assessment, then I don't give them cards and I let them use their own notes, make their own judgments about what should be in the graphic organizer. Students really like concept maps because it's so visual. It's very easy for them to understand the relationships that I am trying to get across, as opposed to just words on a page where they have to draw the relationship themselves.